summary of the formula, and I know you get it, I gave it to you, or I think I emailed it to you, and then I have the outlines and all the different steps. I think here, this is a two-year paper, so. So the work at Colony City, and that's gonna be fiscal year 13-14, Colony D is gonna be fiscal year 11-12, and E is changes in those different steps. Step one, present your professional wages, there's only a difference of $9,000 for one year for that. The service people, we actually took a cut on, service people not being employed without the law. We took a cut on employee-based calls. Transportation expenses, they actually went up $167,000, which I thought they bought some, oh, he bought those cameras, and this is where we're being, like, that we bought this camera, and we did some, he bought some tech, so that's coming back in. Allowance for bus replacement, we've done additional $54,000, which is under the last year. And then there's a new, well, if you look at step seven, and they just talked about it, it was just a little bit, there was some extra money coming in on local taxes, and they put it in step seven, A, we got $53,000. And step seven B is, we've never had step seven B in our county before. It was allocated to us, but it was made to county, but this year, for 2014, it'll actually come to county. But that had increased to $2,000. And I think what we're saying is gonna go with this, is we're gonna try to start finding TISs in some of the step seven funds. And actually, in step seven A, there was a certain amount of that that we had to set aside just for TISs, and I believe it was about $13,000. So I'll look for more and more just that seven to be allocated and set aside for TISs.
TISs.
Technology integration specialist, Sean and Dane and Greg Dawson. And it's not, they're the hardware people behind the scenes, they did everything happen. And then, on line 25, there's the faculty senate amount, $55,000, and that's down $1,800. There's a step seven. Well, what I've done here is these are restricted out of that stated formula, all those amounts are restricted. So, there's 18 million, it's gonna go into general fund. And then in addition to the formula, we get retirement at 1.6 million. And there's that four, and on behalf of retirement library file, it was 4.3 million, I said 4.5, but it's 4.3. So that's a whole new line item in the budget. PIA is 3.1 million. So there's our total formula, restricted and unrestricted. And then on the next page, it's just a breakdown of where all that money is coming from. There's the beginning fund balance. It was last year, I had a beginning fund balance of 1.4 million, and I really dropped that back down. And then, down at the bottom of that page is the county special projects. They have Medicaid, and then there's our levy allocations, how much are budgeted to each of those. There's RMTC at the bottom. So there, all of those numbers make up for 37 million. I just wanted to see compared from one year to the current year on that. That's a good one. Any else to add? That's two more little quickies. personnel. At the top part here, there's our total of 520,000 employees. 8.47 are going to be funded by the state grants. 40.44 are going to be federal grants. 5 have been funded and are considered local sources. 466 need to be funded through the formula. 447 are actually funded, so there's 19 that aren't funded. Now, and I've told you guys this before, even if we start with the formula, then there's some things that I have to do here to get us to what a true number is. So when I look at professionals on line 14, I have 9.45 over formula. I have to add in 5 local positions. And then I have the names over to the side who those local positions are. And I have to take out 1 for the JROTC funding. So the true number is 13.45. Average cost is $60,000. So our professionals are going to be 8.7 miles more. And then on line 29, I've done the same thing with service. You go across, I have 9.617 service. I'm going to let Medicaid fund 8 of those. And then step 7 is going to fund 4 of those. So I actually have a negative amount there. So that's a savings of 9,000. So when I equal all out, I'm going to project that our excess personnel cost $716,447. And I don't know that I've ever seen a number that low. That makes me very happy to see that low number. Basically where we're at right now, we're probably carrying 30 plus or minus people over the formula. Because this is our certified list, so we turn everything in October, you know, they say, okay, your enrollment's 3736, we're going to take out 5.4 for FTE, net enrollment's going to be 3730.6. You have a state aid formula fully eligible, 287.5. We're going to fund 270, so we would be, had we done nothing at all, we'd be 16 over. And then the support, which is the nurses and counselors, we had 10, they would have fund 8.2, so we would have been over 1.79. So we would have been over 18 professionals. Service, 180, they're going to fund 168, so 11. So had we done nothing, we would have been over 30 positions. I just want to show you that's when we started this project, that's where we're at. So then at the bottom is what's actually happening. Once everybody goes through, Trisha just went through all of the changes, we're actually going to have 278. We're going to find 270, and that's going to put 7.3 over. We're going to have 10, and we're going to find 7.9. So it was 2, and then so for professionals it's going to be 9.45 over. And then for service, 178, we're going to find 168, we're going to be 9 over. So that's going to leave us at 19. And then you can see the change there, the 13.65, that's the change from the prior year. Good enough. this 1 year here, that's what North Marcus is looking for, but now, you know, we're just in early. Any questions?
Are you satisfied with the budget you put together?
Yeah, like I said, I've got a little bit of, this year simply, you know, it's a little tight on hand, but I'll work to come back 2014. I